The Air Force Research Laboratory at Kirtland Air Force Base unveiled THOR, or Tactical High Power Microwave Operational Responder, in a live demonstration with local reporters. The system knocked a hovering drone out of the sky with an invisible and inaudible electromagnetic wave as the reporters watched. THOR, which is developed at a cost of $15 million, disabled the unmanned aerial vehicle in a flash and sent it spiraling to the ground. THOR program manager Amber Anderson stated that had more drones been flying within THOR's expansive scope, they also would have dropped in an instant. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how THOR will destroy drones without wielding a hammer. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Drones are no longer just being used as harmless hobby systems. These are being employed as weapons to strike targets at long standoff ranges. Drone technology has become very advanced and relatively cheap. The conflicts in Iraq and Syria have shown that this kind of capability is within reach of even non-state actors. In January 2018, a mass drone attack was witnessed on Russia's main outposts in Syria, the Kamemim Air Base and the naval base in Tartus. Although the damage from the attack was insignificant as per Russia, it clearly displayed the potential of drones in warfare. U.S. President Donald Trump revealed on the 19th of July 2019 that the USS Boxer downed an Iranian drone. As per him, the drone came within 1,000 yards of the U.S. Navy ship and ignored multiple calls to stand down. Mr. Trump, speaking at the White House, had said the drone was threatening the safety of the ship and the ship's crew in the Strait of Hormuz and was immediately destroyed. On September 14, 2019, facilities of Saudi Arabia's oil company, Aramco, located in the east of the country, came under attack. As per reports, the raid began around 4 a.m., and 18 drones as well as 7 cruise missiles were used in the attack. The world's biggest oil refinery near the city of Abqaiq and a refinery near Kuwait, where Saudi's second largest oil field is located, were targeted. The damage was significant, and this caused a spike in global oil prices. It's evident that a swarm of armed drones has the potential to cause a lot of damage. Currently, there are two ways to neutralize drones. 1. Non-kinetic kill approach, where the drone is not hit physically with a projectile. It can be electromagnetic weapons, like THOR, that basically damage electric circuits or disrupt the drone's communication with the ground control station, resulting in them falling out of the sky. 2. Kinetic kill approach, where the enemy drone is physically damaged. This can be done by intercepting the drone with missiles, automated gun systems, and lasers. New age drones powered by AI are more self-resistant and don't need continuous human control, and hence are resistant to electronic warfare. Several new variants of drones can automatically return to the operator even if the communication is lost. THOR uses the first approach. AFRL first exhibited THOR at the 2019 Air Force Association Air, Space, and Cyber Conference at the Gaylord National Resort and Convention Center, located just across the Potomac River from Washington, D.C., in Virginia, September 16th to 18th. THOR is not a hammer-wielding god, but it's a non-kinetic counter-drone swarm electromagnetic weapon that AFRL developed for airbase defense. Stephen Langdon, chief of the High-Powered Microwave Technologies branch at AFRL's Directed Energy Directorate, said, "THOR is essentially a high-powered electromagnetic source that we put together to specifically defeat drones." THOR program manager Amber Anderson says that the system operates like a flashlight and that anything caught in the beam will be taken down in the blink of an eye. It operates from ground power and uses energy to disable drones. Second Lieutenant James Wyrm, a research physicist for the program with the Air Force Research Labs Technology Directorate, said this is designed for base defense. He added, "What it does is that it sends out that high power, short pulse of microwaves that disables the electronics on the system itself." THOR can be packaged in a 20-foot transport container and hence can be easily transported in a C-130 aircraft. Reports indicate that the system can be set up within 3 hours, and its user interface is designed to require very little user training. Further testing against a larger set of drone types in swarming configurations is being planned. The Air Force began testing THOR against short-range targets earlier this spring, while another system, the Counter-Electronic High-Power Microwave Extended Range Airbase Air Defense, Chimera, is designed to hit things at medium to long ranges. Drones can be taken out with traditional methods, like rapid-firing guns, but since they are small and highly maneuverable, this can be difficult. THOR has some very important advantages. The speed enables it to hit their targets almost instantaneously. THOR will also not need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence it will be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. This is pretty significant, as traditional air defense systems can run out of ammunition when encountering a large number of incoming threats. They're silent and invisible, which makes them very much suitable for use in the urban landscape. It will also be much cheaper, as only electricity will be required, and the cost is as low as $1 per shot. This is very cost-effective compared to conventional weapons. It's evident that drones will have a significant part to play in future combat, and the scenario is becoming reality much faster than we could imagine a decade earlier. The US military predicts that swarms of drones will be a major threat in the coming days. Non-kinetic technology is still relatively new, and scientists and engineers are working round the clock to master it. There are many challenges when it comes to using them for combat usages. American military's tryst with this kind of weapon is not new. In 2010, the Air Force mounted and fired off a megawatt-class chemical laser from a modified Boeing 747. Things have changed since then, and instead of unstable chemical laser used for that experiment, solid-state lasers are now being used. The SHIELD program is developing a directed energy laser system that will act as a demonstrator for a self-defense system that could eventually enable aircraft to protect themselves from surface-to-air SAM and air-to-air AAM missiles. On April 23, 2019, the U.S. Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, Self-Protect High Energy Laser Demonstrator, SHIELD, Advanced Technology Demonstration, ATD, program successfully achieved a major goal. A laser developed as part of the program had shot down several air-launched missiles in flight. But the U.S. military is not putting all eggs in the same basket and is also pursuing kinetic solutions. Anduril Industries, which is a small California-based tech startup, has revealed that it started delivering hard-kill drones to the U.S. military that are designed to bring down enemy drones. The drone in question is named Interceptor and was unveiled on October 3, 2019. It's designed to destroy similar-sized, hostile, unmanned aircraft by physically ramming them in air. It'll be interesting to see how things pan out in the coming days. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.